Indiana County, WCCS AM 1160, 101.1 FM, Indiana in the Morning, presented as always by First Commonwealth Bank. And Captain Geoffrey Swires is with us from the Indiana County branch of the Salvation Army. And well, good morning. You brought a couple of folks with you this morning. Introduce them.
Yes, I did. I'll introduce Jess. Jess Bowman has been helping us almost on a daily basis. And with everything that we're planning for the Red Kettle kickoff. Mm-hmm. And it is really wonderful to have her as part of the committee, and it's been great. Mm-hmm. And I'm not sure, am I allowed to introduce you, Tim? Said you're here for moral support only, so I wasn't sure.
He's on Facebook Live right now, so everyone could see him.
But we are certainly glad to have his support and the continued support. We're 12 years now as sponsors of the Red Kettle Kickoff Breakfast, and we are so grateful for that. Mm-hmm. And I know it's become a Christmas tradition for many folks that's how they kick off their Christmas. And since coming to Indiana, it's become my Christmas tradition that I bring you one of our Salvation Army bells to start off the year.
I still have mine from last year back there. I ring it all the time. It still works. It still works. But you still didn't introduce him.
I'm sorry, Tim Cronenwetter. Thank you so much. I'm sorry. I don't get nervous at all. So
no,
this is
I can tell. I can tell. You're getting set to kick off the Red Kettle campaign, aren't you?
Yes, we are. Yes, we are. It's a big undertaking. It's about a third of our budget raised in just under 45 days. Mm. So it's a very large undertaking, but worthwhile because we're able to help the community for the entire year through the generosity of the community during that Red Kettle campaign.
Yeah. So you have an event planned?
We do. The Red Kettle Kickoff Breakfast is on November 13th. It'll begin at 7 o'clock. We've moved it a little earlier to make sure folks have plenty of time to come and visit with us and kick off their Christmas before heading off to work that day.
There you go.
So a new master of ceremonies after many years of helping us, Jonathan Mack will not be our MC this year. We're certainly grateful for all the years that he did that, but he's left it in the capable hands of Jim Struzzi. And as we know, Jim had a wonderful Tuesday this week, and we're hoping he has a great one next week at our Kettle Breakfast as well.
Sure. There you go. Well, let's talk with Jess. And Tim, you can chime in here this morning. Jess Bowman, we were talking, you and I, a couple of moments ago. You've never been in this studio when you were here before on a regular basis. Talking to Chuck.
Yeah,
oh, okay.
Yeah, it's been a couple years though.
Yeah. Let's get a little closer to the microphone.
Sorry.
And we can talk about you and your group's involvement with the Salvation Army and why it's so important.
I think Tim should speak. I'm fairly new with the bank. I've been there just under 2 years, but InFirst Bank has been underwriting the Red Kettle Breakfast for many years now. It's important to the bank as a whole, I feel.
Yeah,
we started 12 years ago, and I think we only had maybe 40 or 50 people at the breakfast at that time. Over the course of the 12 years, I think we're closing in on probably $400,000 that we've collected for the Salvation Army group over that time. It's been been a great opportunity for us, and we certainly enjoy giving back to the community like that.
Absolutely. And our banking institutions here in Indiana County are just amazing. And Jeff, you know this, that without people like InFirst, without people like all of the other banking institutions that really are major parts of the structure of Indiana County, things like this don't happen. You don't have the success that you have, and people aren't helped the way that you can.
It is wonderful, and it's wonderful to have partners that you know you can count on. It's difficult from year to year. Not as many Salvation Armies are that fortunate to have a partner they know they can count on every year to help them start off this Kettle campaign in a successful way.
Mm-hmm. All right. So I called you major before, but you're not major yet. Not till
June.
You're minor until then.
That's right.
You're Captain Swires until then. Fill people in on what the Red Kettle campaign means to you locally and the things that you're able to do here because of efforts such as this.
The Salvation Army has been part of the community in Indiana since 1886. And considering that the Salvation Army arrived in the United States in 1881, it says a lot about how long it's been part of the community here. And the Red Kettle Campaign, it's an interesting thing to say that by giving in November or December, you can help a kid go to camp in June and July, or you can help a child have new shoes to start off the school year. You don't tend to think new school year in November and December, yet you're already helping someone during that time by giving to these things. It allows us to help folks who wouldn't have food. It helps with clothing to help provide coats for children. We've already had our Coats for Kids event, and with the help of the 700 shop, we were able to provide coats for over 200 children from Indiana County who now have warm coats and hats and gloves and are ready for this season.
Yeah, it's just amazing. And you're right. We think of the Red Kettle Campaign, and it's around Christmas time, and we think, okay, so here comes the campaign. This is the only time of the year we can give to the Salvation Army, and it'll fund whatever it funds for now, but it's really about the entire year. And even though the Red Kettle Campaign is so very important, people can give at any time.
Absolutely. We have wonderful people will come in and want to sponsor a child to go to our Camp Allegheny because they know they've experienced that or their children have and been part of that program. It also helps to fund our Arc of Learning after school program, which 3 days a week, children come and the school bus drops them right off, so if parents have to work, that's very beneficial for the parents that their children are in a safe place. They get one-on-one tutoring from wonderful IUP students. Can't say enough about the students from IUP who come and volunteer with us. They're just wonderful. Mm-hmm. And in a lot of cases, the children that they are tutoring, many of them, this is the only person they know who is attending college or has attended college. Mm-hmm. And it makes that opportunity a reality for them. And that Arc of Learning program is able to continue because of fundraising through the Red Kettle Campaign, through our partnership with the United Way, and through people who donate and see the value of these programs for our kids.
Let's talk to Jess and Tim a little bit more. In first, of course, so very much involved with the Salvation Army. Why it's so important to you is one thing, but the fact that you know, something can be important to you and you can give it lip service and say, boy, that's a great cause, but you have to actually get out there and be a part of the effort, and your bank is. Tell us why.
Well, we just finished up last Sunday. We did the 7th Annual Veterans Marathon, and we had some 300 runners from across the country. In fact, we had a lady as far away from as New Zealand, and a lady who won the race was from Alaska. And at that particular event, we probably raised $20,000, and now we're into our 7th year. And we put that money into the Western Pennsylvania Veterans Relief Fund, which is a nonprofit organization, and we've been helping veterans in Western Pennsylvania with fuel bills and with roofing materials and windows and things like that. So it's not, that's one of our premier events, and also the Salvation Army breakfast. Those are the two things that we concentrate pretty heavily on. Being a community bank since 1922, it's an interesting organization. We have no shareholders. And so everything that we do, the depositors basically own the organization, own the bank. And so we feel it's our responsibility to give back to the community. And that's what we do. We're very much a community-oriented bank.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, I remember it actually started out as one of the old savings and loans, which was a whole different type of institution.
It started off almost like a Jimmy Stewart-esque type organization where a number of people got together in town to provide housing in 1922. So if you watch a Jimmy Stewart movie, we really are the Jimmy Stewart Bank.
That's you. Geoffrey said a couple of moments ago that you've been working so hard for this for a long time. Tell us about why it means so much to you to work with the Salvation Army.
Salvation Army has always been something true to my heart. When I was little, I used to go with my pap to a local grocery store and ring the bell every winter. And through my grandparents, I really learned about the love of giving back and helping your community. And I feel very fortunate that I work for InFirst Bank, an institution that cares so much about its community and allows me the ability to do my job and do, you know, things like this, like help the Salvation Army.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay, so.
And I just told her, I said, I have no clue where she's during the day because she's out doing all this great stuff.
It is very rewarding, though. This summer, I participated in the first time with Geoffrey doing the Kicks for Kids, and just getting to be part of that event and seeing how you touch a young child's life just because they got a new pair of shoes and socks for the school year, things mm-hmm. you take for granted. The one little girl just gave us the biggest hug because she was just so happy to have new shoes. So it's very rewarding, and I feel very honored to be able to be part of it.
Wonderful. All right, so Jeff, tell us, if somebody wants to go to the breakfast, what do they need to do?
They can give us a call at the Salvation Army, 724-465-2530, and make a reservation to attend the breakfast. With the breakfast, we have both a live and silent auction. There's some amazing items, including a Disney trip, not just Disney, Universal, the hotel stay, an entire Florida trip. So that's one of the things, and autographed Mean Joe Green jersey. If you're a Steelers fan, we have several things for you. We have a package with two Pirates, two Penguins, and two Steeler tickets. So if you're a sports fan, I don't know that I know anybody in Western Pennsylvania who isn't. But if you're a sports fan, that's there for you, as well as season tickets to IUP sporting events. We have a 8-day, 7-night trip to Mexico. That is one of the items there, as well as coach purses and Dooney and Burke. What am I missing? Oh, we have this year we have an item that is a replica set of all six of the Steelers Super Bowl rings, as well as one that's the Pirates World Series rings.
Wow.
So that's a beautiful thing.
Yeah.
it's pretty neat to see them all together like that, and reminds us how fortunate we are as fans to have that many. But all of these things are available as part of the auction, and that, and I want to say 60 more items are available as part of that auction.
Amazing.
And the tickets are only $15, and the breakfast is at the Indiana Country Club.
There you go. All right, so it's next Tuesday.
That is correct.
Get that number again. Folks got to make the call this morning.
That'd 724-465-2530.
There you go. And we're ready to kick it off. Thank you all for coming in to visit with us.
Thanks. Yeah.
We appreciate
it
so much. It is the voice of Indiana County, WCCS, AM 1160, 101.1 FM.